Hi, and welcome to Couplerio. In this video, we will get acquainted with the interface, as well as take a look at how to create our first data flow from scratch. Let's get started. As soon as you log into the application, you're landed into the home screen right away. This is a place that will help you get started with connecting your first data source. I already did that, but you'll have an option to do so, as well as create a new data flow from scratch. You'll also be able to get in touch with our support for any questions or book a free onboarding session as needed. Later on, we will be adding many more educational videos to this section, so stay tuned. Next up is the data flows. This is going to be the most visited section of the app. There's a good chance of that, and understanding the concept of the data flow is important to understanding how Coupler works. Anything that you get from any sources, transform, and then send to any destination is known as a data flow. So let's take a look at how to create one and then kind of go through the process together. Creating a new data flow is always a four-step process. Number one is connecting your data sources. I already connected LinkedIn ads, so let me just select it. Please note, I'm not focusing too much on all of the different settings here, as we will have dedicated videos related to each one. So let's just kind of go through the flow to get familiar with how it works. So report period, metrics and dimensions, advanced settings, kind of clicking everything, setting things up to my liking. This is all that constitutes adding a data source. I can add more, but for now, let's stick with just one. The next step is transformations. This is a step that will let you not only preview the data once it loads, but also perform certain actions with it, such as rearrange the order, change column names and types to your liking. There is filtering and sorting available, formula-based columns that you can add on a row level, a very powerful feature we will have a dedicated video for, as well as a few transformations. If I click here, you'll see that we have append, join, and aggregate available. Append and join are your blending modes, so they're only available when you work with two different sources. It doesn't make sense to blend anything when you have one. And then aggregation is a feature that lets us quickly summarize high-level insights and key insights from the data set you're working with. Once again, we will have a dedicated tutorial for each of these blending modes and other things you can do in transformations, so let's move forward. The third step is to set up our destination, which is where we will send the data. We can select from an available list here, but I'll just pick Google Sheets for this example and continue with the flow. Select my destination account, select a spreadsheet available to me, and then I can select an existing sheet or type in a new name, and it's going to create that sheet for me. We will have a separate dedicated video on different little tricks and tips, as well as more info on the other settings here. So let's just proceed for now. Clicking save and run will essentially make this workflow execute. And then the final step would be to put it on a schedule. Depending on the subscription, you'll have different intervals available, but let's say I want to update it every single day. Before we move forward, it's a great practice to give any data flows or anything you create in Coupler a good definitive name so that you can always find it with ease later. And let's review the results of what we extracted to Google Sheets. It's essentially a list of the same data that we saw in transformations that was created in the new sheet for us. Let's go back and finish with the rest of the flow. Any data flows, whether it's through the templates or through a process like we did just now from scratch, will be found in a list right here. You can always go back and edit it, make duplicates of it, and remove them in the data flows section. Sources is dedicated to all of the credentials that you will connect into the application. You can change shared access here from private to shared, as well as add more connections, reconnect them, and remove your credentials. Destinations, very similar to sources, except for in here, you will have the menu to manage all of the connected destination accounts, share their accesses, as well as revoke, reconnect, or add new destinations in here. Let's quickly take a look at the My Dashboards and Templates section. So it's very similar to the data flows if we're talking about my dashboards. I don't have anything yet here, but setting up new dashboards will take me to templates. Templates are also based on data flows, and any template I create will be stored both in the My Dashboards and Data Flows section. Navigating the templates gallery is pretty easy. You have your categories, sources, and destinations to filter by. A couple of words here. We have a lot of different templates available for solutions like Sheets and Looker Studio, and are heavily working on adding our own Couplerio built-in templates. Without going into details, we can preview what those are. They're built natively on Coupler, include AI summary feature, and once again, we'll have a dedicated video on the setup process and everything else. When you find a template that you are interested in, you can always preview it by clicking the preview button, and then when you're ready to set this up, just click try report and it will take you to the setup process that will be very familiar to creating a data flow by connecting different sources and sending them to destinations. More videos to come on this. Let's wrap this up now with a quick overview of the settings section over here. This will allow you to invite and manage users. So owners of the account will be able to send email invitations to other people, change their roles from owner to users and guests, as well as revoke invitations. Billing is where owners of the account will be able to manage the subscription, use monthly or annual options, as well as review different add-on offerings that we have available to help on your data analytics journey. And there is a couple of additional settings such as the account and profile to help you rename your organization. And then starting from a certain tier, you'll be able to have people join your organization automatically under the same domain. That's it for today. Stay tuned for in-depth tutorials on all the features and things that we briefly reviewed today. Best of luck, and don't hesitate to get in touch if you need any help.